Had I been 5 minutes earlier, I would have caught a train going over this bridge.
Gloria, I smell it on your breath. Gloria, booze and peppermint. Gloria, no one said enough is enough. Gloria, they found you on the floor. Gloria, my hand was tied to yours. Gloria, did you finally see that enough is enough?
Absolutely. Breathtaking. You spend the entire day in an enclosed forest, then you come out into an amazing clearing like this. Just amazing. And all the way back there is Lake Superior, and we got a good view of it now. Another day's hike, and be right there. We'll be right there with Superior. Tomorrow we'll be right up on it. It's gonna be amazing. I'm not crying. Shut up.
Heaven help me now. Heaven show the way. Get me back on my own two feet. I would lie awake and pray you don't lie awake for me.
Oh. Being in the woods for 3 days, cars sure do seem real fast. Well, here we are. Back on snowmobile trail. I was hoofing it on Reeves road there, and there's a good old boy sitting out there, some guy, his name was Todd. He had a nice Coors Light in his hand. I got talking to him. He's asking me how far I was going. He's telling me, oh, you can take shortcuts if you want. Nah, I don't think I want to do that. Told me I needed to go up to a sign and then I'd take the right there. I did that. I started walking and I walked past it. He comes out to the front driveway from clear down there and he goes, you went too far. I yelled back and I turned around and he says, come this way. So I started coming back that way and saw the old entrance there. So thank you, Todd, helping a brother out. You the man. Enjoy your coolers, man.
I'll lie awake and pray you don't lie away from me. Every night away, every day alone, get me back on my own two feet. I would lie awake and pray you don't lie away from me.
Here at camp, I spent the last 45 minutes trying to get a bear bay line down from a tree, and just could not do it. Half hour, 45 minutes throwing a log at another log, and it just would not go. I ended up snapping the branch off, leaving this much of a little itty bitty branch left on the tree, and it still didn't come off. And I tried and tried and tried, and eventually I cut the line. Just could not do it. That's two bear bag lines that have fucked me. I'm gonna have to invest in a rock sack. Thank you. So it's the morning of day five here on the Superior Trail. Today is a good day. I'll tell you why. New map. Map 3 out of 6. 2 down. 4 to go, baby. What do we got ahead of us? We got a bridge out, apparently. It says you should be able to pass it if it hasn't had a major downpour in the last 48 hours, so let's check on that list. Last night I stayed at the Silver Creek campsite. There were two older ladies there, just out for an overnighter. You know, they had their car parked about a mile away. It was Rita and Sandy. Sandy knew, I use that loosely, what was going on with backpacking. So she had the essentials, she knew what was going on. And Rita did not, so Sandy was super taking charge. And it was really funny to watch and listen to them. I believe they said they had about 3 fuel canisters each, which is just comical as all hell. You could probably go 3 weeks off of 3 canisters. And then there was another girl, she was a southbound hiker, and she was total through hiking. So that means she's doing the lower Duluth part. I think that's like 300 plus miles, something like that. But she's getting close to the end. Her name was Allie. It was really nice to pick her brain. I always enjoy talking to other through hikers, seeing what they have to say, getting some insight from them. She said it had rained all the time the first week or so she was up here, just always raining. So I do not envy her for that. But today we're heading over to Gooseberry Falls. I may stop at one of those campsites. I think there's about 3 or 4 of them in a row, a tenth of a mile apart. And if I get over there in a decent time, I might keep going. Allie made a really good point last night. I told her I was making up miles so I could spend a little extra time in town getting my gear sorted out. Because, I definitely need to do that. Pack's too heavy. And she says, it's a good idea to get the miles out of the way here. That way you can do shorter miles up north where the terrain gets really difficult.
Every night away, every day alone, get me back on my own 2 feet.
Just one more trailhead down.
Pray you don't lie away for me.
This song in my head for the past few days, and it's a song I used to listen to as a kid, so it's probably been a good 10 years since I've listened to it. I decided load her up on the old iPhone, right? So I get my earbuds in, start hiking, hit the play button, and the very first thing in this song is a big crack of thunder. And I was legitimately scared. I looked up, I thought a tree was falling down in front of me, and then it took me a quick second and I realized it was a saw. So yeah, it was pretty funny.
Blah, 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 blah. So you said,
camera will never do it justice. But here's level. Here's what I'm about to climb.
Many people think that's where you go when you die.
Do you?
Well, I think you return to obscure. Or wherever you were before you were. But I won't let you lose yourself.
We're up high and on the ridges today. This is most elevation of the trail so far. We're really high up, the wind's blowing like crazy. Ran into a guy named Neil here a little bit ago, southbound hiker. Yeah, I talked to him for a quick minute. I'm seeing a lot of southbound hikers. I asked him what made him want to do southbound. And the general idea I'm getting from asking people that, I feel it's like a safety net thing. Then they don't have to deal with taking a car up or getting a shuttle, you know, and they're hiking back into society, so it's not a big deal. That to me kind of takes the fun out of it.
Just feet of clay, day won't move if you call in the middle of the night. Just eyelids of plum, day won't open as long as you're inside. You knock on my head, but I can't open my ears to invite your voice in. The silence will last. Oh, I'm tired of all, I'm tired of lay down sleepless rest now. They would decay as soon as they reach your face. You knock on my head. Don't you hear the voice that is ringing in your ears? The silence will last. Oh, I'm tired of all, I'm tired of
lay down.
It's starting to rain. Gotta get that camera rolling first though. We're about to miss out on this action. Oh yeah, here she comes. Find you dirty bastard. So general thing around here, at least to what I've noticed so far, it's just raining right now, right? And it's gonna rain for like 2 seconds. As soon as I get all this ready, bam, she's gonna stop. And it's gonna be real inconvenient having all this rain gear on, sweating like a crazy son of a gun. Now my camera's getting wet, so I'm shutting her off. Hey, would you look at that? Right on cue. All suited up, packing all. I don't hear a damn drop. Kind of thing. Getting rain, eh? Coming up here fairly soon on what's probably one of the greatest spots on the Superior Hiking Trail. There are many areas on the Superior Hiking Trail that are pretty amazing. Great views, great things to see, but there's nothing like this next one, all right? And we're talking about the one, the only, Mike's Rock. Mike's Rock, that's right. People travel all over the world just to see Mike's Rock, get that glimpse at it, and I'm gonna get to see it today.
Ooh, you make me live. Whatever this world can give to me. It's you, you're all I see. Ooh, you make me live now, honey. Ooh, you make me live. Oh, you're the best friend
3:30 in the afternoon here. Looking at my map, kind of weighing my options. For a while there, I was thinking I'd just hike a few longer days, take an off day in Silver Bay or something like that, get cleaned up, get some stuff shipped back. But eyeballing my map a little closer, about 4 miles away, Gooseberry Falls State Park. So I think I'm gonna opt to go there tonight, grab a shower, get my clothes clean to the best of my ability under a shower head, and I'll feel a little fresher here. And then tomorrow I should be able to make it pretty darn close to Silver Bay, where I'm resupplying, if not to Silver Bay. So I think that's what I'm gonna opt for. Last few miles every day, they're real tough. Your body's ready to give out. You just won't stop. I got it. I think that I know why they call it Gooseberry Falls. Because the trail is so narrow here and covered with the slickest mud of all of Minnesota. Gooseberry Falls, more like Gooseberry. You're gonna fall on your ass. Yeah.
Infancy, the seed took root.
Welcome to day six, baby. Just spent the better half of 25 to 30 minutes drying out my clothes that I washed last night under a hand dryer. So, got here so late last night, shower building I've been using, that I didn't even notice this when I came in. Down to a very manageable size now. Feels real well right now. Part of that is because I have a trash can now. Here's all my trash for the week, plus a lot of extras that I brought along that I am not eating. It's probably a good 2.5 pounds here, maybe two. It's going right in the trash. Good riddance. Come on, do it!